Hello everyone, I'm going to start on a new freeform geode again. But first of all, I want to thank someone. I want to thank Barbara for supporting me so much. I can't tell you how much I appreciate it. So Barbara, if you look watch this video, thank you so much for what you did. So this is going to be a very long video, longer than normal. Because I want to show you how I make the mold and also the first and second layer. I already started with a mold. I use again the acetate sheet and I taped it on my MDF board. And I'm using the weather cord again. So I drawn out my shape onto the acetate sheet and now I'm applying the weather cord to the sheet. I also folded the weather cord double, so that it's thicker than normal, so you have a nice barrier in the right height, about 1 centimeter or a little bit higher, and I'm pressing it onto my acetate sheet. And now I'm using a stirring stick to press a little bit of the weather card from the outside onto my acetate sheet to make sure that it's very good attached to my acetate sheet, that it doesn't leak if I pour the resin into it. There you can see it a little bit better how I do it. I also speeded this video a little bit because otherwise we had a 2-hour video and that's not good. So yeah, it's not difficult to do, to make a barrier of the weather cord. All the supplies you need for the mold I have listed at the beginning of this video, but also in the description box, also some links in my Amazon store, so you can check that out. So I'm almost done with the outside. And now the inside again, you can see me make the inside flat with my stirring stick, because you have some small, how you say that, grooves, or, yeah, it's not flat. So I make it flat with my stirring stick, and I hold my hand against the outside so that you don't push it over. And all the way around, I'm making it very smooth with my stirring stick. There you can see it better. And I'm using the same weather cord as I did in my tests. So let's see how long or how many times I can use it. That's also a test what I want to do. So we will find out together. Yeah, now I'm going to add some Vaseline on the inside of my weather cord, of my barrier, because I also did that in a test and that worked very well. And you only need, what I did then is a thin layer, so I'm going to do the same. So with a brush, I take some out of the jar and I apply a very thin layer of Vaseline on the inside of my weather cord, all the way to the top. And I hope it works just as good as in my test, but yeah, we will see. And what I also want to tell you is that before I did applied my weather cord, I first cleaned it with alcohol, and then you have a nice clean sheet. And after I applied the Vaseline, I also cleaned it again with some alcohol. So I'm almost done, and then I can start on the first layer of my geode. So I'm starting with the Bombay ink. I mixed a little bit of ink in it, not too much, because I want to have it transparent. And in the middle I'm pouring some of this color. And on top of it I'm placing some fire glass. And let me look which color. The Diamond Starlight. It's very nice. It's not that large. And yeah. I want to create, after it's done, that you can see through that fire glass. With my steering stick, I push it where I want it. And the next color I'm using is the Bling It Blue of Color Art, very sparkly. And I'm pouring it on top of the Bombay ink. It gives a nice sparkly effect, and both are transparent. Again, some fire glass, but now in the color Neptune Blue, all the way around the Bombay ink. And it's the same size as I have in the middle, but I want to create some contrast. That's why I'm using another color. And again, some Bombay ink all around it. And again, on top of it, some Bling It Blue for the sparkle. Now I'm going to use another fire glass, but then a larger one, and it's in a turquoise color, and it's also going to be all around the Bombay ink. So now I have different sizes of fire glass, and the turquoise color, what I'm placing now on my acetate sheet, is the largest one. So also all the colors and all the materials I'm using in the first layer, you can find at the beginning of this video, but also in the description box. I also listed some of it in my Amazon store. And also the colors I'm going to use are different shades of blue and a little bit of silver. And I'm also going to use some super short glass glitter in the silver and the turquoise color. Some Bombay ink in the middle. And now the next color is the metallic electric blue of Lures. Very sparkly color, very nice. So all the way around the fire glass, this color. And again some bomb paint. The next color is the Bonaire Blue of Color Obsession. Very nice color. No sparkle in it, but I want to have some contrast with the metallic color of Lures. Very nice. And next to the Bonaire Blue of Color Obsession, the Metallic Blue Star Series, also from Lures, and also very sparkly color, to also make that contrast next to the Bonaire Blue. And all the way around the outside, I'm going to use a very nice color of Color Art, the Blue Moon, very dark blue, sparkly color. And the first layer is all about laying those colors down where I want them, and to also already make some contrast between those colors. And in the next layers I will try to add some details. But this is only laying the colors down. Now some heat to make the resin a little bit more liquid, so that the colors can flow to each other or into each other. I like that because I don't like straight lines. It can flow into each other. Then you can get some nice effects. Now I'm trying to blow the electric blue of Lures over the Bonaire Blue of Color Obsession to give it more contrast. And to let it bleed into each other, what I already said. I like that a lot. And now with my stirring stick I push the resin to each other. To cover all the acetate sheet with resin. And also on the sides I push it against the barriers. Adding a little bit more blue moon to the sides. And again some heat. And I'm trying to blow the metallic color of Lures over the blue moon of Color Art. To give more contrast into the blue moon. Now the torch for the air bubbles, and then I will let it dry for 24 hours and start on the second layer. So the first layer has dried for 24 hours, and now I'm starting with the blue moon of Color Art again, all the way around the outside against the barrier. And it dried very well. And I'm very pleased what I already have. Next to the blue moon, another shade of blue. And I used again the blue moon, but I mixed some interference blue in it. Both colors of both pigments are from Color Art. There you can see it. It is a lighter shade than the blue moon, because I want a little bit more contrast there. And next to it, another pigment, but then from Eli Gem, the Region Transparent Blue. And I'm also going to test the Resiblast again, because I put a one drop of Resiblast into this color. So I want to see what kind of effect I'm getting with that, and also if it dries that I have dents or whatever. Now some heat on it, because I want to let those colors bleed into each other. A little bit more transparent blue. Yeah, I want to see if the Resiblast works, and I saw some videos, and I heard that you get dents from the Resiblast, so I want to test that. Next color is again the blue moon with the interference blue mixed into it. Some blingy blue on top of the fire glass in the middle. A little bit of sparkle. And I also added a little bit more fire glass in the middle. And also the Bombay ink again. I made it very transparent. Also around the outside of my fire glass, some Bombay ink. And the Bling It Blue on top of the Bombay ink to give it more sparkle. Again, the electric blue of Lures. Such a nice color, very sparkly. And now I'm using some sterling silver. Also from Lures, a very fine line against the blue moon. And this silver is very sparkly. I like it a lot. I hope I can create some nice effects over the blue moon. Sorry for my friends bulldogs, they are very noisy. And next to it, I'm pouring some Bonera blue again. Very nice light blue color. And I let those colors bleed into each other, what I already said in the beginning of this video. Now some heat. What I also want to mention is that I'm using Stone Coat Art Coat. Normally I'm using Mastercast for my geodes, but I want to also test the Stone Coat if I can create the same effects as I have with the Mastercast. And now with my stirring stick I push the resin to each other or fill in the gaps. And I'm already getting some great effects in the silver. Because normally I'm using Mastercast because it's a thicker resin. And Stone Coat is a little bit thinner. So I want to see if I can create some nice effects with the Stone Coat. I like the finish a lot. It looks like glass. Again some heat, because I want to blow the colors over each other into the blue moon to have some contrast there and to see what effects I can get, because I also use the Resi Blast, what I already said, and yeah, we will find out. Yeah, I'm trying to blow the silver over the blue moon and also the Bonera blue of the of color obsession. What I already said, I'm going to use some super shard glass glitter, and I mixed silver and turquoise together, and also a little bit of resin into my cup. And now I'm pouring it on top of my resin. It's very nice and it sparkles a lot. It's reflective, so it sparkles also in the light. And I'm placing it against the Bonera blue. And it's also like a dam that it doesn't flow, that the Bonera blue doesn't flow too much to the inside or the blue moon. It can be a little bit, but not too much. And with my stirring stick, I'm placing it where I want it. Very not a fine line. It can be a lot of glitter. I like that. Again, I'm using the Bonera, no, not the Bonera blue, the metallic color of Lures. That's the electric blue. And also on top of the edge, some Blinged blue by Color Art to give the edge more sparkle. Again, some heat. The torch for the air bubbles. Again, some Bonera blue. All the way against the glass glitter, because I want to have a light center. With my stirring stick I push it against the glitter. It's very nice glitter, it's super short, so I like it a lot. It's larger than normal. Again, some heat to let those colors bleed into each other and make it a little bit more liquid so that it can flow to the sides. And again with my stirring stick I push the resin into each other. And against the glitter. And I'm already having some nice effects in the blue moon from the silver and the Bonaire blue. I like it. But let's wait and see how it dries. Normally it changes a little bit. Now I'm pouring some turquoise glass glitter on top of the glitter I already have. I think it needs a little bit more. I like it when I have a lot of glitter in my geodes. Again the torch for the air bubbles, and I'm almost done with the second layer, and then I will let it dry. And then I can show you a close-up of how it looks after drying. So this is how it looks after 24 hours of drying. It dried very well. It changed a little bit. I cut some blue moon into the Bonaire blue. And I lost a little bit of my silver. So in the next layer I will add that definitely. Because I like the silver very much. But the glitter is very nice in it. And I don't mind if the blue moon bleeds a little bit into the Bonaire blue. But not too much. It sparkles a lot. There you can see the glass glitter. I mixed the silver and the turquoise into each other. And also the electric blue of Lares against the Viaglass sparkles a lot. It's very nice color, and also the blue moon. Yeah, I'm very pleased. But I'm going to add in the third layer some contrast, more silver. And there you see the Viaglass. I used three colors. The diamond star light, the Neptune blue, and the turquoise blue, also different sizes. There you can see that the blue moon bleeded a little bit into the Bonaire blue, but that I don't mind. But I want a little bit more contrast in the darker part on the outside, so I'm going to add that in the third layer. And also I have no dents from the Resi Blast. So if you like what I'm doing, please subscribe to my channel. Give me a thumbs up for this video. If you have tips, comments or questions, place them under the video. All the materials I'm using are listed in the beginning of this video, but also in the description box. I added a lot of links into my Amazon store. Also from the materials from this geode. So you can check that out. You can also find me on Facebook and Instagram. Also, those two links are in the description box. And I want to thank you all for watching. And I will see you in the next video. Bye!